Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Trendonomics by Harsh. In today's video, I'm going to share my short term update on Nifty, the Elliott wave structure, what are the possibilities, the probability counts in short term as we come near towards the July expiry, end of the July expiry and moving ahead into the August. So what are the probable wave counts, what are the possibilities going ahead? I'm going to share those in today's video. But before that, if you are new to this channel and if you still haven't subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe to this free YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. That's how you are going to receive a notification next time I post a video on stock market, on Elliott Views, on Nifty, on Bank Nifty, on stocks, technical analysis. Go ahead and subscribe to this free YouTube channel and share with your friends. You can follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle, @HarshDikshit84, where I share my lot of stock market related updates on daily basis. You can follow me on Twitter. This is my handle. Okay, so let's look at Nifty. So as discussed, when market breaks this blue moving average, that's short-term moving average, 13-period moving average, on hourly, the trend is likely to go sideways or down, and we are experiencing the same, we are witnessing the same for a couple of days, last at least 5 days. We are going sideways in a range from 11,230 to 11,080. 80 to 90, market getting support near 11,080, 90 levels, and getting resistance near 11,230. We are going sideways for last couple of days, at least 5 days, and we are stuck in this range. And as discussed, this probably the wave two correction going on, and we are likely to go up once we break above this range. So as discussed, Nifty seems to be in wave three, which started at 8,800 and further subsidiary design wave one and two. Wave two completed at 9,500, and further we are in third wave, which is subdividing as one and two. Wave two correction completed near 10,570, and further we are in wave one, and currently we are correcting that rally in wave one, in a wave two correction. Okay, in today's video, I'm going to discuss what happens before every rally. I have already discussed my one of my videos that how to spot big trends in Nifty. In that video, I have already discussed that before going for a rally, market consolidates and forms a base, and then there is a breakout, and then market gives a strong rally. You can check that videos on my YouTube channel, how to spot big trends. So as discussed, we'll first start from where this big rally started at 8,800. So there was a consolidation. Okay. Now suppose we are here before this rally. So now the picture looks like we are in a downtrend, and then we are consolidating in sideways market. So currently at this date near May 20 or maybe May 21, we are seeing it like we are in a downtrend and going sideways. But we are consolidating in a big range, and we are forming, Nifty is forming higher bottoms. The market is forming higher bottoms, as well as RSI is forming higher bottoms. And then there is a breakout of this range, breakout of this trend line, which is ascending triangle, or this flag breakout. This is a channel breakout, which we can say a flag pattern. So breakout of this flag that gave this big rally towards 10,300. So before this rally, there was a consolidation, and then there is a breakout. When RSI gave breakout of this consolidation, when Nifty gave breakout of this ascending triangle and a channel. And before breakout, there was a big red candle. As you can see here, there is a big red candle. Then market starts going up, maybe then making a higher bottom. And then after, market took this high of this big red candle, and then the rally started. This was near 9,000 levels. Again, when Nifty corrected from 10,300 to 9,500. So there was a panic sell off towards 9,500. Then market started making higher bottoms, as we can see over here. Again, there after going above this moving average, 13 period and 34 period moving average, market again gave a panic sell off. So most of the long stop losses will get hit in this panic sell off over here. As we can see, short-term traders use stop loss of the moving average. So yes, in this consolidation, sideways consolidation, you get stopped out quite often. As you can see, there is a panic sell off. Then this big red candle again here. And then market slowly starting moving up and gave this breakout of this symmetrical triangle. Whereas RSI also gave breakout of this triangle pattern. And then this big rally started. Again, we can see after testing 10,550 and then the market went down in a consolidation after breaking this moving average, 13 period moving average. And again, it's consolidating, making higher bottoms. And before this breakout, there is a big red candle. Like in previous, before the previous rallies, there is a big red candle. There is a panic sell off, like here. Even here, near the level of 10,200. There is a panic sell off, this big red candle. And then slowly market start moving up. And then there is a breakout above this red candle. And then market gave this rally towards 10,800. So before every rally, market is consolidating alongside with this moving averages, 13 period and 13.4 period in a narrow range. And then there is a breakout where RSI also gives a breakout. Again, if you see near the level of 10,550 from where this current leg of rally is starting, market is consolidating around the moving averages. And before the rally started, before this rally started, there was a big panic sell-off. Big sell-off, big red candle, but market is making higher bottoms over here. Check here, market is making higher bottoms. There is a panic sell-off, and then market starts going up, some consolidation, and this breakout of this moving average, and then breakout above this candle, of a big red candle. And then the rally continues. Then there is a breakout of this range, entire range, and there is a breakout of RSI. As you can see here, RSI also broken out of this range, and there was a rally. So currently we are consolidating in this range from last 5 days. As we can see over here, there is a consolidation around this moving average. We still haven't broken 34 period moving average. So that's a good sign. That's a sign that we'll still have some strength. But there is a consolidation, and hourly RSI is coming down from 80 towards 44 now. So today we witnessed this big red candle, like the big red candles over here, or maybe in previous, before the previous rallies occurred. So here is a big red candle. Then market slowly started going up. Still, there is not a breakout of this moving average, which is near 11,150, or maybe above this 11,184. That would be a sign that we are going to start a rally again. But now, as you can see over here, RSI has started making higher bottoms over here. The RSI reading here was around 48, and after here ring is about 48.77. So it's a higher bottom on RSI, and on the market it is a higher bottom. As you can see, the bottom over here was near 11,056. Then we have now 11,089, and now we are still not broken out of this range, but we are forming higher bottoms currently. Also, RSI has started making higher bottoms. Now, when market breaks above this resistance line, which is 11,183, and precisely above this resistance line, above 11,220, then we can say that market will start rallying in a third wave, and we can then come up with a third wave target. Once we start rallying, so as per equality, the third wave target comes near 11,700. Okay, but we'll wait until market is consolidating in this range. Once it breaks above 11,220 or maybe above 11,180, that would be an indication that we are going up. Yes, market is following same pattern. Market is consolidating in a range, and there is a big red candle panic sale off, like with what happened here or in previous rallies, before the previous rallies. So there is a likelihood that probably tomorrow we get a breakout above this and we start rallying. So until we are holding above this level of 11,080 to 90, there is a chance that market will break above this consolidation and we would go higher. So we are holding with the stop loss of this 11,080 to 90 level and expecting a breakout. Bank Nifty is comparatively weaker currently. So as discussed, this is a rally in wave one and probably expanded flat wave two. And again, market started rallying in wave one over here, but today market sold off below this 13 period moving average. That's a weakness, sign of weakness. But we are still holding above this 34 period moving average on daily chart. And we have this support of this rising channel, trend channel. So we'll go on early chart. So once probably this is five wave rally as wave one, and we are correcting in wave two. So probably this is wave A, B, and C. So once we break above this level of 22,400, 22,500, then probably we can start expecting a rally in third wave. Until then, there will be a weakness in Bank Nifty. Yes, currently at support and oversold level, nearly oversold levels at major support. So let's see how Bank Nifty behaves. Probably there is a pressure on banking stocks because of the July expiry. Maybe after the July expiry in August, banks start pulling up and giving a good rally. So definitely this number 21,700 to 21,800 is important support, and 22,500 to 22,800 is an important resistance. So we'd watch for this resistance being taken out near 22,500 and 22,800. Then we can expect to rally. So that was about Nifty and Bank Nifty. We'll watch the price action in coming week going ahead, and then we'll decide where the market likely to head. Always use a stop loss. Always trade with stop loss. So we are holding this Nifty trade with this stop loss near 11,080 to 90. Okay. So that was about Nifty. I'm going to come up with a webinar where I'll discuss how to identify market leaders. So stay tuned. Keep watching. Keep sharing. Keep learning and keep sharing. Thank you.